Hello and assalamu alaikum. This is continuation of lecture number 6, and in this part of the lecture I will discuss about the tidal, wind and biomass energy. These are the types of renewable energies. So in the previous part of this lecture I have discussed about the hydropower, and from here onwards this graph is showing the percentage of total power share due to that has been reduced from generation of hydroelectricity due to the use of renewable energy. Because the hydro energy consumption is significantly reduced with the increasing trend of renewable energy. So in this chart, from years 1950 to 2015, fall in hydroelectric power share due to rise in renewable sources, which include wind, solar, nuclear and other forms of energy, has been depicted. So now I will discuss about the tidal power. Tides are believed to occur or form due to the gravitational pull of moon and sun, along with the centrifugal forces that are associated to the rotation of earth. Tides can go up to 40 feet and might rise from 40 feet above level in some places. Economical production of tidal energy requires at least 10 feet of tidal range. Tidal barrage installed along inlet of ocean bay or lagoons forms tidal basin. Sluice gates on barrage control the water levels and flow rates. So using these gates we can control the filling of these basins. We can allow the tidal basin from incoming high tides, and they can be emptied through turbine generators. Two-way tidal power system generates electricity from both the incoming and the outgoing tides. These are the two examples of tidal power stations that generate 254 megawatts of energy from Shiva Lake in South Korea and 240 megawatt of energy using tidal energy in La Rance, France. The second one is considered to be the oldest and second largest power plant that makes use of tidal energy to make electricity. Now let's discuss about the turbines for tidal power generation. We all have seen the wind turbine in our university. The tidal turbine looks like the wind turbine with the only difference that it is placed on the sea floor or in the path of strong tidal flow. So, as the windmill can be lighter because the density of wind is low as compared to water, so a tidal turbine must be sturdier and very heavier as compared to wind turbine, because the water density is 800 times the density of air. So overall, its construction is more expensive, but as the flowing water has a lot of energy, we can generate more energy with the same size blades. Tidal turbine projects in Scotland and South Korea have 1.5 megawatt tidal turbine. Project in Scotland planning to have up to 400 megawatt generation capacity. So this is how tidal turbine structure is embedded in sea. Its base is grounded in seabed, and the tides will rotate its fins and it will produce electricity. Now let's discuss about the wave power. Waves are generated when wind blows over the surface of oceans and lakes, and waves have a tremendous amount of energy. West coast of United States, Europe, coast of Japan and New Zealand have the potential sites for harnessing wave energy. So following are the 3 points when we consider the production of wave power. First of all, we bend or focus the waves into a narrow channel to increase their size and power in order to spin the turbine that generate electricity. The second, channel them into catch basin or reservoir where water flows to turbine at lower elevation, like in hydroelectric dams. Its principle is more or less same like a hydroelectric dam, but on a small scale. And third method is to place device on or just below the water surface and anchor them to the ocean floor. So this is an example. The device is on floating and it is anchored using these anchors in the seabed. The next comes the biomass energy. Organic matter that comes from plants and animals is known as biomass. Chemical energy in biomass is released in the form of heat when the biomass is burned. The biomass energy is said to have zero footprint of carbon. I'll discuss this, it in a while. The biomasses can be burnt directly, or they can be converted into liquid biofuel or biogas to be burnt as fuel. Wood and wood processing wastes burn to heat building to produce process heat in industry and for the purpose of generating electricity. Agricultural crops and waste materials like that of waste material of sugarcane is burnt as a fuel or converted into liquid biofuels. Similarly, the wood waste in garbage is burned to generate electricity or converted into biogas in landfills. Biomass is considered to be carbon neutral technology because biomass consumes carbon dioxide during the production process, and it is estimated that the amount of carbon dioxide that is absorbed during production level is almost equal to the carbon emission that is generated during the combustion process of biomass. So, it is said that net carbon dioxide emission of biomass is zero. So, they are considered to be carbon neutral technology. The next one is the biofuels. The biofuels are the transportation fuels such as ethanol and biodiesel made from biomass. Usually, they are blended with petroleum fuels like gasoline and diesel, but they can also be burned on their own. They burn cleaner as compared to the fossil fuels, and cleaner burning means that they produce less carbon emissions. Ethanol or alcohol fuel made from sugars, which are found in crops, these are known as ethanol. The next one is biodiesel that is made from fats and vegetable oils. Biodiesels can be used in diesel engines without need of any kind of modification. They are non-toxic and biodegradable and produce much lower levels of air pollutants than पेट्रोलियम बेस्ड और फॉसिल फ्यूल बेस्ड डीजल फ्यूल। कॉमन ब्लेंड ऑफ डीजल फ्यूल इज B20, विच मीन्स दैट इट हैज 20% ऑफ बायोडीजल एडेड इन इट। सो दिस इज द कंजम्पशन चार्ट ऑफ यूनाइटेड स्टेट बायोडीजल कंजम्पशन फ्रॉम ईयर 2001 टू 2017। इट इज सोल्ड विद दिस लेबल दैट यू कैन यू शुड यूज इन व्हीकल्स फ्रॉम 2001 एंड न्यूअर पैसेंजर व्हीकल्स, बिकॉज फ्रॉम 2001 ऑनवर्ड्स द कंप्रेशन रेशियो ऑफ द डीजल इंजन्स हैव बीन सिग्निफिकेंटली इम्प्रूव्ड। सो फ्रॉम 2001 टू 2007 द ट्रेंड ऑफ बायोडीजल कंजम्पशन वॉज इन ऑन द इंक्रीज, देन इट डिक्रीज एंड समवट स्टेड कॉन्स्टेंट, एंड नाउ इट इज इंक्रीजिंग एक्सपोनेंशियली। द नेक्स्ट वन इज द विंड एनर्जी। विंड एनर्जी इज द एनर्जी इन द एयर फ्लो caused by the differential heating of earth due to the heat produced by sunlight. Daily wind cycle over coastal areas. During the day, air above the land heats up faster than the air over water because the specific heat of water is quite high. Warm air from the land expands and rises, and the cooler air from the sides rushes to take its place, and this process creates wind. At night, wind direction reverses because air cools more rapidly over land as compared to the water, again because the specific heat of water is higher. Atmospheric wind circling the earth are created because land near the equator is hotter as compared to the polar regions. So this is the trend of wind electricity generation and percent share of total United States electrical energy from year 1990 to year 2070, and it can be seen that the wind power generation is also on the increase, and from 2015 onwards it's nearly 7% of the total generation. Top 5 countries in wind electricity generation and their shares in the world total energy generation in year 2015 is United States by 23%, China by 22%, Germany 9%, Spain 6%, and India 5%.